Hello Taurus, how are you? Welcome to my channel, Star Star Star. So Taurus, this is your reading for the month of May 2021 and this is a general reading. So please take what resonates and leave what doesn't. Energies might be vice versa and time is fluid. Okay. Also, I would appreciate if you would hit like, share and subscribe and comment down below if you find yourself getting resonated with this reading, right? I would also request you to hit that notification bell so that you will be notified whenever I upload the videos. So Taurus, this reading has an extended reading as well. So if you're interested and if you find yourself getting resonated with this reading, you can click on the link that has been provided in the description box. You can click on the link that has been provided in the comment section, and that will lead you to the extended reading on Vimeo. Make sure you follow me on Vimeo and as well as you follow me on YouTube. Okay, so you'll have to hit that follow button on Vimeo, and on YouTube you have to hit the subscribe button. Okay, so that's how you get notified whenever I upload the videos. So the structure of the extended reading has been mentioned in the description box. Okay, you can refer that. You can also refer the trailer. However, I would quickly like to reiterate that the extended reading is divided into two parts, part A and part B. Part A is everything about your person. Part B is everything about you. Both the parts are equally important. Okay, part A is like we are going to deep dive as to what your person is thinking and feeling about you, what your person in what action they intend to take towards you, what advice they are getting from the family and friends. When it comes to part B, it's an advisory section. To be honest, I enjoy part B much more than part A because it is about you and it is so much it is so much optimistic and futuristic, right? So it's about I will advise you as to like what is the advice when it comes to this connection, what is the advice if you want to move on, what is the advice for your life in general, what is the advice for your money, finances, career, and at the end we'll pull out some affirmations, right? So Taurus, thereafter, so this was about extended reading, and if I have to talk about this reading on YouTube, what I'm going to do is I'm going to place a couple of cards over here. They will represent your energy, then I'm going to place a couple of cards over here and they will represent the energy of the person you're thinking about, you're dealing with. In between, I'm going to place a couple of cards and they will be the general messages, they will be the non-love messages for your person and for you, okay? And thereafter I'll pull some oracle cards and they will be the messages from higher powers, they will be the messages from the universe. At the end we'll see some love notes, and with the help of love notes we'll see what your person is thinking and feeling about you. Okay, all right Taurus, let's get started. So for you, we have Five of Cups, Ten of Wands, Magician, Taurus. For them, we have Ten of Cups, Queen of Swords, Four of Swords. Mutual energy is Eight of Wands, Ace of Pentacles. So if I have to talk about the zodiac signs, Taurus, you may be dealing with Aries, Virgo, Aries, Leo, Sag, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. Okay, and I'm sensing Scorpio. Five of Cups and Ten of Wands and the Magician. Taurus. I believe that Taurus, you're taking action towards what is serving your highest good. Okay, you are keeping that in your mind and you're taking an appropriate action in that direction. Okay. So like I feel that it's been a quite a disappointing phase. It's been quite a turbulent, emotionally turbulent phase with this person of yours. And you're tired and you're exhausted. You're tired and exhausted of thinking about them. You're tired and exhausted waiting for them. You're tired and exhausted getting mistreated by this person. And now you are like, you're thinking to yourself, why am I even carrying this burden? Okay? You know in your mind, you know what your heart is trying to tell you. You know what your brain is trying to tell you. You know what your soul calling is. Okay, and you are like, why am I not listening to myself? Okay. There is a lot of emotion for this person, there is no denying about it. But there has to be, you need to get what you deserve. Right? You cannot keep on begging for that. No one should beg for what they think, what they deserve. Okay? And if you are, if you're reaching that stage, then there is something, definitely there is something wrong in that. You're like, why am I even carrying this burden? Number 11, number 10 is of some importance over here. You may be seeing a lot of 11, 11. You may be seeing 5, 5, 5, okay? Because there is some sort of a change, a major change that is about to happen. I would put it in this way that, there is a major cycle that you're completing in your life, okay? You're almost nearing to completing that cycle. And after that, there is so much of abundance. You're gonna feel so light, Taurus, once you complete the cycle, okay? With this person, or there is also, I'm also sensing that it's not just with this person, okay? You're completing a life cycle. Okay, there is a cycle in your life, and that was a phase where you had to go through a lot of disappointment, you had to go through a lot of ups and downs, okay? And you are getting out of that cycle now, and now you're gonna feel so light. You're gonna feel that some sort of a burden that has been taken off of your chest, okay? And there is so much of abundance. There is so much of abundance after that. Okay, I also feel, Taurus, that you are going to become a powerful human being. When I say powerful human being, what I mean is not that some supernatural powers are going to come towards you, but your manifestation powers are going to increase. You will be more, a growth-oriented person. You are going to focus more on yourself. Like, whatever, every single action that I take in my life, is it serving my highest good? So you are going to start thinking from that perspective. Okay? And you will become so attuned to that automatically that you will quickly start manifesting and attracting abundance, love in your life, whatever you want. Magician is like, a magician has all the tools, right? Look at it carefully. A magician has a wand in his hand. A magi On the table, there is a sword, there is this cup, there is a pentacle. So there is everything. Okay? A wand in his hand, a wand over here, right? So he has everything. A magician is very powerful, right? So he has all the tools at his disposal and he can use them the way he wants. And with that infinity symbol on the top of the head, it only means that you will have some infinite opportunities, you'll have some infinite powers. When I say powers, don't like, don't try and think yourself as a superman. What I'm trying to say is you will get opportunities and you will develop yourself in such a manner, okay, that you will start attracting abundance, you will start attracting happiness and satisfaction and money in your life, okay? Without much work, you will start attracting, like, you're not going to become lazy, but you will know what are the tools and the resources and how to use them so that you can attract that abundance and you can attract that you know, whatever is meant to come towards you, you'll attract that easily. So look, what happens is, there is this poverty consciousness in our mind, okay? We are being trained to know that, you know, only after hard work, then only you will get what you deserve, okay? And if you start getting abundance easily, if you start getting money easily, you are like, oh, this has come to me so easily. Do I even deserve that? Your mindset, your mind and body is so attuned to that ideology that only if I work hard, then only I'll earn this much money, okay? But, okay, it's, of course, hard work is also important. I'm not saying that hard work is not important. I'm not advocating becoming lazy. But what I'm trying to say is, if things are coming towards you easily, accept it with open arms. Welcome it with open arms. Okay, don't doubt that. If universe is sending to you something easily, don't doubt the intentions of universe. Like, oh my God, how come I have received it so easily? Did I commit some mistake? Did I do something wrong? Or it has come to me by mistake? No, it was meant to come towards you. So change this poverty consciousness. Okay, change this thinking that only after hard work, then only I'll get X and X things. Okay, and that's what you're doing. You're bringing a change in your mentality. You're bringing a change in your thinking. Okay. As far as your person is concerned, 10 of Cups, 10 of Swords, Queen of Swords and 4 of Swords. They're thinking a lot, but there is a third party over here, okay? And this third party is still sort of an hindrance between you and them. This is what they want with you. They want 10 of Cups with you. And they are thinking about approaching you for that. Okay, but this is the third party who is stopping them with the sword in her or his hand. Okay, a third party, maybe because we have it next to 10 of Cups. For some of you, this person may be married, or this person is in long-term commitment with that person. Okay, and the third party knows about you, Taurus. The third party totally knows about you. Okay. And this third party is stopping this person from coming towards you. This third party is stopping this person from achieving this abundance and happiness. But they're finding out, they're thinking, what are the means and the ways to avoid the third party and come towards you and express what you want to. Or not just avoid, but think, they are trying to think as to how they can get out of this third party situation. Because they want to experience this happiness with you, Taurus. They clearly want to experience this happiness with you. Okay? Mutual energies, 8 of Wands and Ace of Pentacles. So, both of you know there is a potential, okay? Both of you love one another a lot, okay? No denying about it. There is a lot of love in the situation. The problem is third party. The problem is, not enough of communication at the right time. Not taking action at the right time. Too much of delay, okay? And that is also one of the reasons, like, you're feeling like, why I should be the only one who should keep on carrying the burden of this relationship. I don't want to carry the burden of this relationship. I'm offloading the burden of this relationship from my shoulders. I'm not alone responsible to run the show for this relationship. If it has to be, there has to be two people responsible, equally responsible. And this person did not take the responsibility initially, right? So let's see what are the other messages, Taurus. What are the other messages for you, Taurus? And we have is Knight of Wands, 4 of Swords, again, Emperor for you. 5 of Cups for your person, 8 of Cups, and the World. Yeah. With that 8 of Cups and with the 5 of Cups and the World as well, okay? this person is walking away from third party. They are not happy. They are not happy in the situation at all. Of course, they are not happy without you as well. But this third party situation is literally like, you know, is taking away the life from them. Okay, so they are walking away from the third party situation. They are completing the cycle with the third party. Okay, but is it too late? Is it too late? Because you are already headed in the direction where you are dropping the burden of this relationship. So I don't know if it's too late. We can see that in the extended reading. So if this resonates, you can check the extended reading for more details or for that kind of action they want to take towards you. So Knight of Wands, Four of Swords and the Emperor. You are looking in a different direction. You are looking in a different direction, Taurus. I also see that you have become a bit ambitious. You have become more, you're changing. Basically, you're changing, okay? You're shedding your old skin and you're changing. You're transforming right now. There is one of the reasons, of course, there is a lot of self-awareness that is brewing inside. There is a lot of realization that I shouldn't have allowed this person to walk over me. Okay, apart from that, I also see there are some domestic responsibilities on you, Taurus. There are some domestic responsibilities on you. You wanted to enjoy your life, but all of a sudden some domestic responsibilities have come onto you. Okay, and you are handling those responsibilities, but there is something that you want some happiness as well in your life. It's been long you have experienced such true happiness and you are craving for that. So let's see what are the messages. What are the general messages? So what are the general messages for this person? What are the general messages? Or what are the messages from higher powers? What are the messages from higher powers? Taurus. Messages from higher powers. Appreciation. Then we have door to personal healing and happiness. Community. And cornucopia. Ooh. Career-wise, you guys are rocking. Okay, Taurus, you people are really rocking when it comes to career. There is a lot of abundance, lots and lots of abundance coming your way. Okay, and more so I'm feeling materialistic abundance. Okay, and I feel that you're going to start business with your friends or something. I see that you're getting into a partnership when it comes to your career, your profession. You are getting the appreciation at your workplace. You are being recognized for the efforts that you are taking. Door to personal healing and happiness is also your spiritual growth is helping you to heal yourself. That's what I'm getting over here. Okay, and something related to the friends. Either you're going to meet someone like whom you haven't met for a very long time, or either there is something you're doing with your friends, getting into a partnership with the friends, but there is something related to the friends that is going to happen, and that is going to bring a lot of happiness to you. Okay, let's see what are the messages from the universe. What are the messages from the universe? Start wherever you are. You're planning to start something. You haven't started, just started. Things are about to get juicy. Everyone is doing their best. Do not doubt anyone's capability. Forgiveness. Someone is going to ask forgiveness. Create space for new love. You know that. Somehow I'm feeling you're sensing you're moving in a different direction. A direction opposite to this person, past person of yours. Hubba hubba. You know that dreamy look of deep soulful love you have sometimes seen in the eyes of another as they gazed into your own. Expect a lot more of it. You are adored. Someone is adoring you. Someone is admiring you. Let's see what this person was thinking and feeling about you, Taurus. Okay. Now, take how it resonates. Some of the love notes may look like what you are thinking and feeling about them. Some of the love notes may look like what they are thinking and feeling about you. You treat me like your prince or princess. You call or text me to see if I'm okay. You say silly and cute things to make me laugh. We know we can work things out together. You care and comfort me when I'm in a bad mood. You have magic hands that can fix everything. The way you love me, holding your hands while watching a movie is just awesome. If I die tomorrow, I would know I found my soulmate in this life. I can't imagine a minute without you. Touching you is the most wonderful feeling ever. You laughed at my jokes even when they are not funny. How you share everything with me. If all I ever had was you, that would be enough. Interesting. You have the cutest smile on the earth. Alright, Taurus, I hope this resonates. Please hit like, share and subscribe and comment down below. Till then, bye. If you're interested, go and watch the extended reading. The link has been provided in the description box. Okay, bye-bye.